Let us now study about an illustration on heat dissipation in charging a charged capacitor. In this situation, here the figure shows a capacitor which is charged by a 20 volt battery with polarity as shown in figure. It is saying if the switch is closed, we are required to find the amount of heat produced till capacitor attains a steady state again. Here, if we calculate the initial charge on capacitor, this initial charge we can calculate as CV. Value of C is 5 microfarad and initially it was charged by a 20 volt battery. So it is 5 multiplied by 20, that is 100 microcoulomb. And if we close down the switch, as battery polarity is also of same order in which the capacitor is connected, its polarity remains same, but the charge is increased to the new value of CV. So here we can write final charge on capacitor is Q final, that is also CV. Here we can write this as V final and V initial. So this will be 5 multiplied by 30, that is 150 microcoulomb. And if we correspondingly calculate the energies of capacitor initial and final, that is before and after closing the switch. So here also we can write initial energy is given as UI is half CVI square, that can be written as half multiplied by 5 multiplied by 20 square. So here the value we are getting is 2000 by 2, this 1000 microjoule, that can also be written as 1 millijoule, but here as all calculations are in microjoule, let it be as it is. And we further calculate final energy in capacitor is U final, this is half C V final square, this is half 5 and 30 square. So the value here you can see it is 900 multiplied by 5, that is 4500 by 2, so this is 2250 microjoule. So in this situation here we can calculate a delta QF, that is charge flown through battery, that is during switching. This can be directly given by QF minus QI. The value is QF is 150 microjoule, QI is 100 microjoule, so this will be 15 microcoulomb. Now if we calculate the work done by battery, you can now calculate work done by battery after switching. That can be written as delta QF, which is flown through the battery multiplied by the battery EMF. So this we can write as charge flown as 50 microcoulomb multiplied by the potential of potential difference across the battery. Here we can write as 30 volt. So the value we are getting is 15,000 microjoule, because the value of charge is in microcoulomb, so unit will be microjoule. Now in this situation, if we calculate the heat absorbed by capacitor in switching, this delta U absorbed can be given as the final energy minus initial energy. Final energy is 2250 microjoule and initial is 1000 microjoule. So the energy which is absorbed by capacitor due to switching is U final minus U initial, that is 2250 minus 1000. So this is 1250 microjoule. This is the amount of energy which is already there in capacitor, which is absorbed by the capacitor. So in this situation we can directly calculate the heat dissipated in this process can be given as work done by battery which is supplied by the battery minus delta U absorbed by capacitors. So this can be given as work done by battery is 1500 microjoule minus the amount of energy absorbed by capacitor is, here you can see it is 1250 microjoule. So the final result we are getting is 250 microjoule. That is the result of this problem. And if you make use of the direct expression I have given you at the time of concept video for calculation of heat, then you can also directly get this result without all this calculation. This is alternative way for which you can write in any circuit. This we already studied, heat dissipated can be directly given as delta Q whole square by 2C, where delta Q are the summation of all the capacitor changes in the circuit. Here you must be very careful that delta Q for an individual capacitor may be different, and here if we substitute the value of delta Q, here this given as 50 whole square divided by 2 multiplied by 5. So this will be 2500 by 10, this is 250 microjoule. That is the answer to this problem.